It is 11 o'clock in the morning. Because when I wake up at 11 o'clock, I'm supposed to be late. I'm 4 o'clock, I'm awake. Why do you think, why don't you think why? Think about it. If this was put in 45, should we keep it up to now? Why can't we think about a place that isn't comfortable? The other point, America, the hosting country that bears the expenses and the looking after the headquarters and the looking after the peace and security of heads of state who come here, very strict, and they spend a lot of money, and New York and the whole of America being very tight. I want to relieve America from this hardship. We should thank America, and we say to America, thank you for all the trouble that incurred upon itself. And we say thank you to America. We want to help America. We want to make America secure, New York secure, and we should not have the responsibility of looking after the security. Perhaps somebody would do any terrorist would make an explosion or a bomb of an aircraft, a president or more killed. And then this place is a target targeted by the Al-Qaeda, this very same place, the same building. And if it was, and why? Because on the 11th of September did not hit it, that was beyond their power. And the next target, that would be, and I'm not saying this out of off the record, we have tens of members of the Qaeda being detained in the Libyan prisons, and out of their confessions, very scary. And this makes America lives in under tension, and perhaps you never know what will happen. Perhaps America will be targeted again by a rocket, or by perhaps tens of head of state may die. We want America to relieve America from this worry, and we shall take the place to a place where it is not targeted. Now, after 50 years, should be taken to another part of the hemisphere. 50 years in the Western Hemisphere. Now, and for the next 50 years, should be in the Eastern Hemisphere or in the Middle Hemisphere, like this by rotation. Now, 64 years. Now we have extra 14 years over the 50 years that the quarters should be have taken from this. This is not any insult to America. This is a service to America. We should thank America. This was possible in 1945, but we should not accept it. Now, and of course, this is also put for vote in the General Assembly, only in the General Assembly, because Article 23 of the Agreement 64, it says that like 51.
بعتقد ما عشنا ما نش مجبرين نتحمل هذا التعب كله. لما نجي من الهند ومن الفلبين ومن استراليا توصل عندنا ومن جزر القمر وين صار شفت اخير رئيس احمد جزر القمر 14 ساعه في الجو وقال تعال اخطب في الامم المتحده كيف يخطب هو لا حتى التوقيت بتاعه تغير بعد القيود اللي ضايقوا منها الناس
After the America has the right to make any tight securities because America is targeted by the terrorists and by Al Qaeda. America has the right to take all the security measures. I mean, we're not blaming America for that. But we don't to tolerate these measures. We don't have to come to New York, and we don't have to be submitted all these measures. One president told me that your co-pilot should not come to America because there are restrictions. He said, how can I come, how can I cross the Atlantic without a co-pilot? Why? He doesn't have to. He doesn't have to come here. One another president complained that his guard cannot, his honor guard cannot come because there is some misunderstanding in his name and granting him a visa. He came, another president came, he said, my own doctor, he couldn't get a visa and he cannot come to America because he was not granted an entry visa. You see the security measures very strict, and of course if there is any problem that that country has with America, then they will put restrictions for the movement of the member delegations, like in Guantanamo. Is this a member state of the United Nations, or is a prisoner in the Guantanamo camp that he cannot allow free movement? So this is what is submitted for voting for the United, for the General Assembly, the transformation or the moving of the headquarters. If 51% say, then we come to the second vote, to the middle of the globe or to the eastern part of the globe. If we say that we have to take the headquarters, then the place is certain in Vienna, whether the central hemisphere. Why don't we go to CERT? If you go to 1,000 kilometers and no one can blame you. And no, if you can come even without a visa. Once you come with a president, it's a secure country. We are not going to restrict you to 100 or 500 meters. And Libya has no hostile actions against anybody. And Vienna, I think, will be in the same positions. And if the vote, it say that we shall have to take the vote to the eastern part, then it will be Delhi or Beijing in China, the capital of China, or the capital city of India. And this is logic, I believe, my brothers, and I don't think there will be any objection to that. And then you will say that you thank me for this proposal, for eliminating the suffering and the trouble of flying over 20 hours and 15 hours to come to this place, and no one can blame America, plus even though this place is targeted by terrorists. Then we come to the issues that will be taken by the General Assembly. Either we have to try ourselves, either we do the right thing or whether we have a new thing. This is not a normal meeting. This is not a normal gathering. This is, even my son Obama said that. He said this is a historical one. This is not a normal gathering. This is not a normal one. Now, the wars that took place after the establishment of the Second World, why did it happen? Where was the Security Council? Where was the Charter? Where was the United Nations? There should be investigations, and there should be court orders, and why there was massacres. We start with the Korean War. This was taken after the establishment of the United Nations. How a war broke out and millions of people fell victims, and perhaps there was even a nuclear. The war was about the world was about to witness a nuclear war, and those who are responsible and those who caused the war should be tried and should bear the consequences. Then we come to the Suez Canal war in 1956. The file should be open. Why three countries who have permanent seats in the Security Council enjoy the right, the veto of the Security Councils, attack a member state in this General Assembly? A country that is Egypt, in this case, that was a sovereign state, was attacked, and the army was destroyed, and thousands of Egyptian people were killed, and towns of Egypt were destroyed. How such a thing happened during the era of the United Nations? And how can we guarantee that such a thing will not be repeated unless we redeem the past? And this is a very dangerous thing, the Suez Canal War, the Korean War. We should open the files, and then we come to the Vietnam War. 3 million victims of the Vietnam War.
استخدمت في حرب فيتنام خلال 12 يوم.
During 11 days, bombs were used more than the bombs used during the whole war. During the Second World War, all the shells or the bombs that were used or bombed during the 4 years of the war, the bombs that were used in the 12 days were more than. This was a fierce war, and this war took place after the establishment of the United Nations, and we decided that there will be no wars. This is the future of the mankind, and we cannot keep quiet. How can we be safe? How can we feel accomplished? How can we feel complacent? I mean, this is the future of the world, and this is the General Assembly of the world, and we have to make sure that such wars will not be repeated in the future. Then Panama was attacked, even though it was an independent state, member state of the General Assembly of the United Nations, and 4,000 people were killed, and the president of this country was taken as a prisoner and was taken, put in prison, and Noriega should be released, and we should open the file, and how we give the right to a country that is a member state of the United Nations to go and wage a war against a country and take the president of such a country and take him as a criminal of war and put him in prison. Who would accept that?